I've gone through all my life without going up steps like these. Oh, Tommy, I'm so ashamed. It's okay now. I don't believe we're doing this.
I don't like these places.
See one, you've seen them all, ain't you?
I'd rather go to the dentist.
Yeah, me too.
Oi!
What? I'm a taxpayer.
Yeah? What about him?
Look after him for me, will you, Henry?
Yeah, okay.
I've got to go inside.
Okay.
Hello!
What?
Are you trying to kill me?
I wonder how he's getting on.
Just look at his milk. Solid.
He wouldn't harm anyone, that man.
Who? Robbie?
Gentleman.
Told me he was a painter. Just looking to stay at that bloody wall.
They won't keep him, would they?
They can do what they like with him, as far as I am concerned. And what about this milk? It's bloody solid. Look! Concrete! Don't just stand there, get a cloth.
And in view of what the Crown Prosecution Solicitor has said, I shall remand you in custody for 7 days. For the following reasons. I believe you will fail to surrender to the court. The serious nature of the offence, the probable method of disposal, and that you have no fixed address. Then I must warn you that you are entitled to apply to a judge in chambers for bail.
Look at it. Ruined. Bloody ruined.
Hey, you don't suppose he's done this thing he's up for, do you?
They nicked him, didn't they?
Oh, come off it, Gil.
Well, he'd do anything to get out of painting that wall.
Gil? Ew.
Alibi.
Living it up all over the continent.
Somebody's got to do something.
Nice here, isn't it? What I like about remand is you're doing time in your own club.
The three of us are still not guilty. Until the jury go one way or the other, you can sit in and you're always in with a chance.
I am guilty.
Shut up, dear.
Just stating a fact?
You'll be the one who gets off most, probably. You're the gambling man. I run a book. First offence, is it?
Yeah.
You don't bat for the other side, do you?
Leave off, will you?
It's just if you did, you might do all right.
What makes you so sure he didn't do it?
Because if he'd wanted to get involved in that sort of thing, he would have done it years ago. He's had plenty of opportunity, believe you me. He is 44, you know.
That's just when some people begin, Mrs. Oliver.
Begin?
Middle age and fear of the pensionless 60s.
He's not like that!
Sorry. As your solicitor, I'm trying to find out how strong your case is.
Yes, I see. I'm very sorry.
Now, it's my job to brief counsel on Mr. Box's behalf.
Yes, of course he must have a brief. Yes, I see. Just you make sure he's a good one.
Keep in line now. Keep in line.
Why didn't you use the jury solicitor?
I didn't know. I've been up all night, questions coming from everywhere.
Should have had a brief.
You know what it's like, you think you've found your solicitor, then you realise you haven't got one. It's not the same as the pictures, is it?
Well, they've
got
to get you one.
Well, you try telling them then.
Right, keep it down, keep it down.
You boss. I hear you're a gambler, man.
Yeah.
You don't know me, do you? I'm the body in the boot merchant, Deans.
Oh, lovely.
There might be a game.
In here?
Well, I'm not going to let us go out to the pub, are we? You on?
Don't know.
Well, think about it, eh?
Could I see the menu, please? You're going to go out of here fat.
Dick!
I shouldn't bother with none of that.
Dick!
He could have come back last night, late. You never know.
No chance.
He's only gone over for a motor.
Look! Pratt?
Me?
Nah, the Pratt that left him there.
Just took on cases regardless, any to learn.
Well, you thought wrong, Mr. Box. Now then, the facts, please.
The facts? I don't know any facts. I wasn't there. I was looking for a game. The old Bill was looking for something bigger. They showed me these pictures. I mean, it's ridiculous.
£50,000 is a lot of money. Do you usually play for those sort of stakes? Why this time?
It's a long story.
Here, he wants another chip.
Come on, come on. Tipper, Ferry, come on. Let's be having you quick.
Oh, what's up?
Everything's up. And I'm going to sort it all out. Go on, get up, all of you.
Hey! Number 11, backwoodsman, 3-1.
Where are you lot going?
They're with me!
They're with me!
Oh, come on, all...
Oi!
What?
That's my dinner you're taking out there.
Why did you go on a diet then? Do your ulcer a power of good. Come on, let's go, everybody. Yeah, pay that dog.
The stock exchange. That's where it is. Buy at a good time, sell at a better. Well, it is a gamble, but the odds are better than the horses.
Is that right?
Absolutely. Your move.
Well, if it's so easy, what are you doing here?
Oh. Slip of the computer.
Why?
Well, I was playing with someone else's money, and the computer fed out the wrong information. But to the right people. Never trust a machine. Stick to the scratching pen nib and the piece of parchment. Checkmate.
You're not dealing with idiots, you know, Vi. Those sort of people eat you for breakfast.
What people?
The people he plays cards with.
Hard men.
Yeah, hard men, but they all had mothers. Just remember that.
What does that mean?
Well, it means that at the end of the day, they all need their nappies changed.
I wouldn't like to suggest that to Ronnie, dear.
Why don't we just spring him?
Ferret, I thought you were going to be of some use.
We'll never get him out of there.
It's been done before.
Oh, look! I'm trying to prove that he's innocent, not guilty.
Let's consider the situation.
Yes.
Dick's disappeared. Day's done a runner. And Brookman's left for the States. So where can we go from here? It's hopeless.
It isn't hopeless, Jan. I mean, look, Hitler tried to bump me off in the war, but he didn't succeed. I'm not going to let a few photos and a coincidence stand in my way.
Hmm. Yeah, could be right.
Dinosaur.
Thought about it, Box.
Yeah.
And?
I'm still thinking.
Don't think too long.
Get on with it, Dines.
Dick, without a witness, I'm cat's meat.
We had a postcard.
Oh, yeah.
Where from?
Germany. Hotel in Germany.
Well?
I tried, but they've moved on again.
I can't stay in this place, Princess. I didn't know what freedom was until I came in here. There's not a minute of the day or night when you're on your own. You can't even sit in the cars here without somebody sitting next to you. The only place you can be on your own is in here. That goes away soon enough. I've got to get out of here. You've got to get me out of here, Princess.
Come on. Box, pull yourself together.
Sorry. You should have put some orange in this cheek.
Mm-hmm.
Every human being needs their own space, their own time. You don't realise it until you come into a place like this. You don't realise how enjoyable it is to be on your own shaving in the morning until it's taken away from you. Got to appreciate it, Princess. I mean, whatever you do, you've got to appreciate it.
Finish your visits now, please.
Oh, come on, Debs. We'll be out of here soon, don't we?
Come on now, ladies.
Come on, stop it, will you?
I can't.
Charlie Mayer, he won't entertain me.
He won't?
It's on account of that VAT business. Says he hopes Robbie gets life.
Oh, he does he?
Oh, I'm spitting feathers for a cup of tea.
Right. If he won't entertain you, I shall entertain him.
Perhaps we could come to some agreement then. How much?
Is he?
Who?
Your brother.
He don't work for me anymore.
I didn't ask whether he worked for you. I asked, where is he?
Germany.
Germany?
Yeah, Germany. He goes to Germany, buys new BMW cars, he brings them back and he flogs them, all right?
Where in Germany?
I don't know, lady.
Listen, I might need you as a character witness.
You what?
Dick. When are we going?
Hey?
Home.
Home? What's wrong with the continent?
Nothing.
Well, enjoy it then.
Listen, if Davis wants my ear rolls for breakfast, let's wait till he's lost his appetite, eh? Decadent, isn't it?
What?
Tea in the afternoon.
I don't understand what's going on.
Danes. What about him? Who's asking again?
Are you gonna...
With all I've got on my mind, he's gonna be joking, isn't he?
Beautiful, am I? Do you know what, babe? I constructed this all myself. Mechanically minded, don't I?
Can we please get back to Robbie, Mr. Davis?
Yeah, all right. How can I help you?
Well, he's got to prove where the money came from. Because they say he did this burglary.
Did I?
Well, how would you feel if they accused you?
Look, babe. Robbie is a very clever boy, but he's got himself in a bit of trouble. Now he'll have to get himself out of it, won't he?
But he can't, can he? Not without witnesses.
What witnesses? They don't exist!
So you're telling me the game did not exist?
What a shrewd lady you are. Right in one. There was no dame.
They're going to put him away, Mr. Davis.
No justice, is there? Look, love, I'd like to work with that, but I can't. You see, I've been called as a witness myself. For the prosecution.
You're an animal!
Hal Brookman.
Mr. Hal Brookman?
That's right. Brookman.
Mr. Brookman checked out this morning. Have a nice day.
Well, thank you anyway. Yeah, you too. Have a nice day. Damn. I traced him to Vegas, and he's moved on. I don't believe this case.
Neither do I.
Over those briefs to wish her luck tomorrow. A woman?
Well, that's right.
What's a woman know about the law?
Eh?
Should have had a man.
Looks better in court.
Tommy, a woman knows more about the law, the making and the breaking of it. Ever since they took the rib out of Adam.
A man should have a man to defend him.
Out.
Eh?
Go on, get out. But get out.
But why? I was only making an observance.
Well, make your observance somewhere else. Go on, get out.
Well?
Nearly there.
Anything from Dean?
No, not yet.
Well, if it goes the wrong way, Jack.
Look, we'll all be having a knees up the day after tomorrow. You'll see.
Yeah.
To get the fags, right? Well, I called in at the casino.
Charming.
Well, I just couldn't resist it. I think we'd better go home.
I see. Broke, are we?
Not exactly, no.
What's that?
It's another BMW.
Another cup of tea.
Were you looking for a particular person, Inspector?
No, sir.
All the photographs your people were taking?
Routine. All clubs are covered at one time or another.
And did you notice anything significant during your surveillance?
Yes, sir. We observed one man, the defendant, entering all three places.
And the defendant is a friend of Simon Anscombe, one of Lord Bruton's close circle of gambling friends?
Yes, sir.
Now, I'm sure I have all the facts correctly. Lord Bruton is an exceedingly wealthy man. Anscombe, who has incurred heavy gambling debts, some of them to these same clubs, has disappeared. And the day after the burglary at Lord Bruton's home, in which £50,000 was stolen, the defendant, Anscombe's friend, is £50,000 richer?
Yes, sir.
Yes. It's a truly amazing coincidence.
Thank you. That is yours. Don't get lost.
Where did you first meet Mr. Box?
Oliver's club. That's where Mr. Box still owned it.
Did you buy the club from him, Mr. Davis?
Well, he couldn't afford to keep it running.
Mr. Davis, will you answer the question?
In a manner of speaking, sir, yes.
In a manner of speaking?
I did buy the club from him.
Could you comment on the defendant's financial state, as it seemed to you at the time?
He was skinned. I'm sorry, Your Honor, he was short of money.
The other names that we mentioned this morning, Mr. Day, Mr. Aldino, Mr. Brookman. Are they friends of yours?
I know Mr. Day and Aldino, but I don't know Brookman.
Do you do know of Brookman?
Yes.
Yes, would you describe him as a sort of a folk hero in the world of poker?
He's the governor.
So, if Mr. Brookman were in town and wanted to play poker at your club, would you have agreed to that?
Yes.
Even if... I ask you to consider your reply carefully. Even if it had meant breaking the law and putting your club license in jeopardy.
Definitely.
Yeah, 9 and 10, please, love.
Both yours.
What, the pumps?
No, the cars.
Oh, yeah, yeah. His and hers.
What's she been up to then?
Eh?
Well, you didn't get him out of a Christmas cracker.
Oh, no, no. I did a Robbie Box, didn't I?
Robbie, who?
Mr. Davis, could you tell the court what you were doing before you settled back in London?
I was working on the boats.
And what were you doing on the boats? Were you a captain, a purser, a seaman?
No, I used to get involved in the card games.
In other words, you were a professional gambler on the boats?
If you like.
If you like, Mr. Davis. Did you know that Mr. Hal Brookman was in town recently? Mr. Davis, I put it to you that you did. Would you like to think again?
No.
Are you a friend of Mr. Ronald Day?
He's an acquaintance.
And Mr. Frank Aldino?
With me.
Is it not true that Mr. Aldino, because of other commitments, could not attend the game, and that his, Mr. Aldino's, seat was sold to Mr. Box for 25% of Mr. Box's winnings?
I've told you there wasn't a game.
25% is a lot of money, Mr. Davis.
Depends.
25% of nearly £70,000? Is this usual?
In a game of that kind, yeah.
In a game of that kind, Mr. Davis? I put it to you that the card game did take place at your club, that four of the participants were Mr. Robert Box, Mr. Hal Brookman, Mr. Ronald Day, and yourself. And that Mr. Box left your premises £50,000 better off than when he arrived.
Trying to watch where you took him.
You have a plan, Joe.
Who?
Right. You take that one back now. Got it?
Yeah.
Why did you stay with Mr. Mayer that particular night? The night of the burglary at Lord Bruton's house.
I was waiting for a phone call from Ronnie Day at Dick's to tell me if the game was going to be on.
And did he call?
Yes, but it was supposed to be a big secret. I mean, Dick shouldn't have been there.
Did you have much to drink?
Well, there was the bottle that I took and whatever Dick had there.
And the next morning, Mr. Mayer left for Germany to buy a car.
Yes, but he should have been back in a couple of days.
Yes. Could you tell the court about the money you'd saved up over the last few months?
Well, every time I had a win, I put some of it in a jar. It's what I called the Brookman account.
And why was that?
I was saving up for the day when Brookman came back to town again, so I'd have enough money to sit down and play poker with him.
And you knew he would come back?
I knew he would, yeah.
What's up, love?
I can't stay in there any longer, Tom. It just isn't working.
Well, of course it is.
No, Tom. They're going to put him away. I know it.
Immediately afterwards, Mr. Day goes abroad. Likewise, Mr. Anscombe. And Mr. Mayer goes to Germany. It would appear, Mr. Box, that your friends are excessively fond of travel.
Mr. Day and Mr. Anscombe are not my friends.
That's for the jury to decide.
But I went looking for them because I wanted to find out where the big game was going to take place.
The famous game that Mr. Davis denies ever did take place.
I had to blame Brookman. I've been waiting and waiting.
Brookman, the man you say took £10,000 from you the last time you played together.
That's right.
You're prepared to lose another £10,000?
That's right.
So, this is a gambler's life, is it?
Don't get you.
Losing money.
I won.
I'm very glad to hear it. But this money, this entrance fee to this mythical game, was it easy to come by?
You're kidding, no, I never stopped grafting.
Grafting?
Working.
Well, how did you do that?
Gambling.
Oh, I see. So far as you're concerned, gambling is working.
Well, yeah, and then some. I'm like, all right, I don't go to an office, but I go to Gill's, a bookmaker, every day. I sweat my cobs off when a horse goes behind the starting stalls. All right, I mean, I probably expend more mental energy than playing a game of poker than the boss of the Bank of England. I've made my own way through life, all right, and without hurting or being harmful to anybody. I play poker and all that kind of things, but that's the only thing I can do. I mean, it's a turn of a card, the nose of a horse, the speed of a greyhound or something like that, but I earn it. I mean, I suppose if I'd done this on the stock exchange, it'd be considered legal. Whatever you say, I'm not a thief.
Silence!
Mr. Box, you must allow counsel to speak.
Sorry.
Oh, can't wait to show Rob. Come on. Hello, Barry.
Hello.
You like the new motors?
Very nice.
Fox, this cigarette lighter, Exhibit 3, Your Honour. Is it yours? Is it yours?
Yes.
Then how did it appear at the scene of the crime?
Somebody must have put it there.
Yes.
Leave it. We ain't got time. Do the map reading.
How long have you known Mr. Box?
8 years.
To your knowledge, has he ever been involved in any form of criminal activity?
No.
What sort of work has Mr. Box done over the years that you've known him?
Work?
Yes.
None.
Then how does he make his living?
He's a gambler.
He makes his living on the turn of a card?
Yeah.
Mrs. Oliver, as a gambler, Mr. Box would need money to gamble with, would he not?
Yes.
Yes.
But he would never steal any...
Just answer the question, Mrs. Oliver.
So, where would the money come from in the first place?
Well, he would have accumulated it over a period of time.
How long a time?
Well, he had his ups and downs.
Yes, I'm sure he would. The money that he used for this alleged game, how long a time did that take him to accumulate?
I don't know. I know he'd been saving for months.
Mrs. Oliver, didn't you once squander your life savings on a card game? On the turn of a card?
No. That was his money, not mine.
But he did squander £10,000, did he not? Wouldn't you agree that anyone capable of doing that is also capable of getting involved in a burglary that would line his pockets with £50,000 and then put on the turn of the next card?
No, no, no! I could never marry a man like that.
Sorry. Look, pal, my name is Dick Mayer.
Thank you, Mrs. Oliver.
Mr. Mayor.
Your Honour, a witness I consider important to the defence case has returned to this country and has just arrived. I would be grateful for the opportunity of taking instructions before I examine him.
I will allow you 5 minutes.
Thank you, Your Honour.
Number 8, Aztec Gold.
Is this what you wanted?
Number 4, wax candle. Number
6, yeah. Curtain raiser. Oh, he ain't got a cat in the house, Charles. Goose jaw.
And so, very drunkenly, you both decided that the best place for Mr. Box to sleep was in your flat.
That's right.
How much did you drink?
A lot.
Can you be more precise?
Not after that much. I don't normally drink at home. I'm a pub man.
But you were together that evening and the whole night?
Yeah.
One final question. When did you last see Mr. Box?
On the morning I left for Germany. I dropped him off at his old club.
Thank you, Mr. Mayor.
Bye. They're doing their final speeches. Want to come?
No.
You believe a man when his own words admits to never having worked in his life. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, if it were that easy to accumulate £10,000, we'd see a line of bookmakers standing on the dole queue, not on the racecourse. The defendant's story is an out-and-out fabrication, complete lie from beginning to end. Defendant is a small-time gambler, a purveyor of untruths, and a thief. There should be no doubt in your mind that the man you see before you committed the crime which enriched him by £50,000. Well, the evidence has been presented to you should leave you in no doubt. Let's look again at the facts. A cigarette lighter, which he admits is his, found at the scene of the crime.
Why, if the defendant is such a liar, as my learned friend has gone to great pains to point out, why, if he is such a liar, did he not lie about the night of the burglary? Surely it would have been simpler for him to have claimed that he spent the night with Mrs. Oliver, which he did on most other nights. What have been called untruths by my learned friend are the facts. A strange sequence of events, no doubt, but nevertheless, the facts. Mr. Box did spend the night at Mr. Mayer's flat, and they did consume a considerable quantity of whiskey. The next day, Mr. Mayer did go to Germany, and that same evening, Mr. Box did play poker with Mr. Davis, Mr. Day, Mr. Brookman, and one other. And Mr. Box did win £50,000. Ladies and gentlemen of the jury, I do not ask you to admire Mr. Box or his way of life. I do ask you to accept that he is a gambler, not a thief.
Members of the jury, I don't propose to start my summing up this afternoon, so we'll adjourn until 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
The upstanding court.
The lighter what done it?
He's had it, hadn't he?
Yeah.
I was dreaming of the past, and my heart beating fast.
I began to lose control. I began to lose control.
Evening, ma'am. The name's Brookman.
Hal Brookman. I sure hope I'm not too late.
Well, I come to London about once a year to take in the sights, play a little poker. Well, I am known as a high roller, which means that, well, hell, ma'am, I won't even take off my hat unless there's 20 grand out there on the table. Yeah, well, anyway, at the last minute, another player was required for this particular game. Oh, and Mr. Box, right over there, who on a previous occasion had lost a considerable sum to me.
What about the shop?
I'll go to the shop.
Robbie Box won that entire pot fair and square at a club called Oliver's, owned by this Peter Davis. Now, when news of this case finally reached me, well, I got over here just as quick as I could, because I knew he'd be in a fix, and, well, ma'am, one thing I never could do is leave a long-tailed cat in a room full of mousetraps, if you know what I mean. Well, I'd also like to say here that, well, this here's the man who beat the man, and, well, I'd be right proud to sit down and cut a deck of cards with him any day of the week. And, well, I guess that's about it, ma'am.
Thank you, Mr. Brookman.
Would the jury foreman please stand? Members of the jury, have you reached a verdict upon which you are all agreed?
Yes.
Do you find the defendant, Robert Box, guilty or not guilty?
Not guilty.
See ya.
Well done, Robbie.
Thanks very much, Leslie.
We're off, mate.
Listen, make your holiday shorter next year, will you?
Rob, what's going to happen to Davis?
They're going to do it for perjury. And I tell you something, if they push him a bit harder, they might find out how my lighter got there.
Oops. See ya.
Oh. This your party, sir?
Yeah.
Been a few complaints.
Oh, sorry.
So, perhaps you could...
start winding up. Yeah, certainly, yeah.
Thank you, sir. Oh, and... congratulations.
Oh. Would you like a drink?
Well, you never ask.
I told you it would.
Yeah, but you didn't believe it though, did you?
We're off now, son.
Oh, not yet.
Decided we are going to take that place in the country.
You're not.
We bought it.
Well, you're London, you're not cowpats and straw.
I know, but, well, I'm going to give it a try. Be lucky, son.
See you, sex bot.
Cheers, Jan.
What's the manacles, Tom?
See you later, Rob. See you later, Mum. Keep at it, you two. You never know. Just might work out.
So you finally had it off at last, eh?
I hear you tried to earn a few pennies on the result. Come on, Susie.
Bye, Jane.
See you in the betting shop. Oh, I want that wall done.
I'm taking the wall home in the wagon.
Over you, Geordie. Good night.
John?
The shares that are actually issued
are combined to form the issued capital.
What was that?
Somebody had a result, a bit like me.
You're here again.
Good evening.
See ya.
Right. Your place or mine?
Oh,
listen, I forget. Don't go over £50,000.
Oh.
And the other thing was the proposal.
What proposal?
In the court.
Oh, that was a slip of the tongue.
Oh, yeah?
Mm.
Oh.
Come on, gambling man.
I'm serious about giving it up, you know.
Oh, yes.
I'm thinking of taking up the stock exchange next.
Oh, the stock exchange?
Suited, booted, bowler hatted. What more could you want? And, this is how serious I am.
Wow-wee! Have you still got that ring?
Yes. Yes, I've still got that ring.
Yeah. Handy things, rings, aren't they?
Yes. Very.
Next week at this time, all the best of Dave Allen as he chooses his favourite sketches from over 1,000 which he'd recorded during the course of the series Dave Allen at Large.